Guidelines on Assessing Signs, an Examination of Violence Against Older Persons was recently published by the European Council of Legal Medicine, ECLM. The main purpose of the guidelines are to provide a common framework for healthcare professionals and forensic practitioners to properly document and evaluate potential victims of elder abuse. In order to determine whether an older person may be a victim of violence, the document gives the following general principles. Informed consent should be obtained prior to any examination. If the older person does not have capacity to consent, the appropriate steps must be taken to ensure a lawful examination is undertaken. A detailed review of the event under investigation should be performed and inquiries made for any previous history of abuse or possible abuse. Undertake a full medical history, including medical, surgical, gynecological, psychiatric, and medication history. Screen for all types of abuse, as more than one modality can be simultaneously present. Perform a full clinical examination of the older person. Appropriately sample, collect, and preserve all physical evidence. Request further investigations as required by the specifics of each case. Determine the appropriate course of action in order to protect the older person, secure their rights, and avoid further abuse. Keep in mind that for a complete investigation, it may be necessary to perform more than one evaluation. Research shows that emergency department staff rarely recognise or report elder abuse. The need to identify elder abuse in emergency care is actually more important than in other healthcare settings because emergency room visits are unplanned, leaving perpetrators and victims little or no time to hide evidence of violence. Healthcare professionals may be the only people outside of family who are in contact with an older person soon after victimisation. Older patients are a special group in emergency departments because they use emergency medical services more than others, and their reasons behind seeking care are more often related to serious illness which demand acute care. A common perception among healthcare professionals is that older people often use emergency services for psychosocial reasons such as loneliness or feeling unsafe. However, there is no scientific data supporting this perception. This common misconception about older people's use of emergency services can affect the attitude and behaviour of emergency department staff, making it harder for older people to disclose sensitive issues such as experiences of violence and abuse.